so it's the time to take up this question, that is question number 4, which says, suppose a mass m is moving along a straight line with some initial velocity, which is u. So we are given here the initial velocity as u. It is uniformly accelerated to velocity v. Okay, so it means it is uniformly accelerated motion, and hence we can apply the equations of motion. In the time t, by the application of a constant non-zero force F, the correct relation between F, V, U and T can be. Now here, if you have a look at the options, option number 1 says U is equal to V plus F by M into T. Now we know the equation is V is equal to U plus AT, and A can be written as F by M. But here this is u is equal to v plus f by m into t, and hence this option is the incorrect option. Option number 2 says v is equal to u square minus f by m into t, which is already incorrect because we don't have such equation. So if we have a look at the third option, this says v square minus u square is equal to f by m into t. Now we have the equation v square minus u square is equal to 2as, and hence this option is also incorrect. We have the fourth option as m in the bracket v minus u is equal to f into t, and we know f is simply the rate of change of linear momentum, and hence it can be written as f m in the bracket v minus u by t. So this option is going to be the correct option. I can mark it here. I can also write it here that answer of this question is option number 4. Let's quickly move on to the solution for the next question. Hey, so let's take up this question. This says a ball is projected vertically upward with a velocity u. So we are projecting the ball in the upward direction with velocity u from the ground. If t is the time taken by the ball to reach the maximum height h, we are given the maximum height h, and we are also given the time. That is not the time of a flight. This is the time taken by this ball to reach this maximum height h. So do remember this. Then what will be the height of the ball from the ground after time 7t by 5. So here, if we try to solve this question, I can simply write this t, which is the time that is taken by the ball to reach the maximum height, will be given by u by g, and we know the maximum height is given by u square by 2g. We need to find out the height at time 7t by 5. So I can apply the equation s is equal to ut plus half at square, and if I just take this to be small h, that will be u. Instead of t, we need to substitute what? We need to take it as 7t by 5. So I'm just going to write it as 7t by 5, and this will be minus half g. This will be 7t by 5 whole square. Now if I just substitute the value of t here as u by g, which can be written as, this will be 7 by 5 u square by g, and this will be 49 by 50 u square by g. And on solving this, I will get h as 21 by 50 u square by g, and that can be written as 21 by 25 capital H. So this h is 21 by 25 h. So option number 4 is the correct option. So I can mark here. I can write here that correct answer for this question is option number 4. I hope this question is very clear to you. Now let's quickly move on to the solution for the next question. It's the time to discuss the solution for question number 6. Let's read this question first. This says, four identical blocks each of mass M are placed on the top of a trolley of mass capital M as shown in the figure. When a horizontal force of magnitude F is applied, so here we are given this force F, and this is applied on this trolley, it experiences an acceleration A. Further, the question reads, if one of the blocks picked up gently from the trolley while F is still being applied, the trolley will then accelerate. We need to find out the new acceleration of the trolley. Okay, so in the first case, I can write that as this question says, M and M always move together. So all the masses are going to move together. So what is going to be the net force? That is F. We are applying the force F on the trolley. So that will be capital M plus 4m into a. So this is the acceleration with which the trolley is moving. Okay, so that can be written as f divided by m plus 4m. Now the question further says, if one of the block is picked gently from the trolley, so we are removing one block, okay, so the force remains the same, so that is again f. The new total mass will be m plus 3m into a dash. Now this force is same, so I can write a dash as m plus 4m in the bracket multiplied by a divided by m plus 3m. So if you have a look at the options, you can clearly see here that option number 2 is the correct option. I can mark this. I can write here that correct answer for this question is option number 2. I hope this question is also very clear to you. Now let's quickly move on to the solution for the next question.